Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, the service today will be starting at 2:15. In the meantime, before that, we will be playing some music. There'll be some welcome words beforehand.
Event happen once again, especially with the building work that has been ongoing throughout 2016. The Ride to the Wall Committee have worked tirelessly throughout the year, not only planning this year's event, but also over the past 6 months putting planning into place for our 10th anniversary. The merchandise and registration team have processed your orders quicker than Amazon. The rider logistics and parking team, along with the marshals, have planned better than a Formula One pit stop. And the social media team endeavour to answer any questions before you've actually finished asking them. All this is done by a dedicated, committed team of unpaid volunteers who take pride in what they do so that we can all remember those that gave their lives for their country. Along with those members past and present that have served our armed forces and our Queen. It allows us the opportunity to come together for one day of the year as one family to remember, reflect and hold on to memories both happy and sad. Unfortunately, Major General Kirkland cannot be with us this year due to family commitment. But it gives me great privilege to introduce our new in-service patron, Lieutenant General Paul Jakes. Thank you.
Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. As Martin said, my name is Paul Jakes, and I'm delighted to be the new serving patron of the amazing Ride to the Wall charity. Just as I've been embraced by the Ride to the Wall family, I would like to welcome you all, especially the family and friends of those remembered here, to the 9th Ride to the Wall at the National Memorial Arboretum. We've ridden to this beautiful place from all over Europe, on bikes, scooters and trikes, to come together as a community to remember and honour those who have given their life in the service of our country. The Armed Forces Memorial behind you in this fantastic National Memorial Arboretum commemorates those who have died in conflict since the end of the Second World War. This monument is such a beautiful setting, is extremely poignant, and seeing it, especially for you all, drives out the pressures and irritations of daily life. It quite quietly demands reflection and reminds us of the sacrifice made by soldiers, sailors and airmen through time. The country is remembering the 100th anniversary of the Somme Offensive. And it was 100 years ago today, and I think it was pretty much the same weather, that the British began another battle for the Transloy on the Somme. Over a million soldiers were killed or injured in the 141 days of the Somme Offensive. It is an unimaginable number of lives that were affected. And I certainly struggle to grasp the scale of that loss. No doubt many of us, whether families or veterans or serving military, will be here to remember and commemorate in our own ways loved ones and colleagues who have been lost more recently. I'm very grateful to have been given the opportunity to join you and to remember the friends and soldiers of mine who have died or been wounded in operations over my 33 years of service, in particular in Iraq and Afghanistan. The scale of your commitments as bikers to this day is overwhelming to a first-time ride to the border. And I would like to thank on your behalf, the Ride to the Wall founder, Martin Dickinson, and the charity's trustees and volunteers for all their hard work in making this special day happen. I've had a small glimpse behind the scenes, and it is clear that there is a huge amount of dedication, effort, and goodwill required in making this ever-expanding event the success it is. As you know, Ride to the Wall is a charity that raises money to help maintain this wonderful place. The 8th year saw it pass the £500,000 mark, with £100,000 being raised last year alone. Thanks to all of you who have supported and continue to support the ride. It will be a fitting achievement for Martin and all those responsible for setting up Ride to the Wall if this total could be surpassed this year to help raise money for the continuing upkeep of the National Memorial Arboretum. On behalf of Ride to the Wall, I'd also like to thank the National Memorial Arboretum team, led by Sarah Montgomery, for not only helping to run this day, but also for your hard work in making this memorial even more special every year. On a personal note, I rode here in my old VM, a companion of 27 years, and what a thoroughly enjoyable and unique experience it has been to join several thousand bikers, all riding to the same destination with a united goal of remembrance. For me, it created a bond within this biker community that I thought was unique to the military. As a serving soldier, I would like to thank you all for your support for this event today and over the years. It is humbling to see so many of you come together to honour and pay respects to those who no longer ride by our side. Thank you. I now hand over to Simon. Earlier this year, somebody asked me what the Ride to the Wall was all about. Unsurprisingly, my reply focused on the fact that it's an annual gathering of bikers at the National Memorial Arboretum to raise money for this most worthwhile of causes so that we can continue to remember those that we have lost. Of course, that is what the Ride to the Wall is about. Although in truth, it is much more than that. Judging by the amount of activity on social media and elsewhere in real life, the Ride to the Wall is a permanent community in its own right. It clearly operates in accordance with many of the core principles that define
almost certainly be planning this year's attendance since you rode away from last year's event. You'd quickly conclude that the ride to the wall means a great deal to an awful lot of people throughout the year, not just the first weekend in October. This is a fantastic organisation, an extended family, and I am very proud to be part of it. As I have said before, this is a special day. This is a very special place. And you are very special people committing your time and money once again to this incredibly important cause. Your continued support and contribution to the right to the wall, whether serving, veteran, or any other kind of supporter, is a unique and unqualified demonstration of what defines the British Armed Forces and what defines the Brotherhood of Fighters. You have my gratitude and respect. So thank you for listening, thank you for attending, and thank you once again for your contributions. Safe ride home, and see you next year for the 10th.
Good afternoon, everyone, and on behalf of the National Royal Marines, it's a pleasure to justice we hold before you those whose memory we cherish and those whose names we will never know. Help us to lift our eyes above the torment of this broken world. Grant us the grace to pray for those who wish us harm. As we honour the past, may we put our faith in your future. You are the source of life and hope now and forever. We pray for our families, those we love. Touch them with your love, guard them with your strength, and surround them with your protection, we pray. Amen. God grant to the living grace, to the departed rest, to the church, the queen, the commonwealth, all people, unity, peace, and concord, and life everlasting. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and those you love, now and always. Those among us who want to lay wreaths, please do so now.